friends, welcome back to another episode in our YouTube playlist for Stage 100 Contractor. My name is Caitlin and I'll be taking you through today how we can create a 6-9 proposal for a job based off of our 9-5 takeoff. So follow with me. I'm going to go ahead and open up the sample company. For those who are new to the sample company, it is not related to any specific company or anything related to Bangert at all. It's more of a sandbox or demo company for you guys to play around in. First, I'm going to go ahead and open up 9-5 takeoffs. If you are new to the estimating module, this is an add-on feature that you guys can purchase to kind of emphasize more of your project management for Sage and really focus on your bidding process and workflow. If this is something that you guys want to look at buying, go ahead and send me an email or our coordinating team an email and we can get you set up with a demo to then show you how it can work for your company. For those who already have the estimating module, you guys are already familiar with the takeoff screen. So I'm going to go ahead and open up one job that already has a bid created for it. You'll see that I opened up 224. The shoe shop is what we're going to be basing our demo off of today. And they have broken this down into bid items and cost codes. So they've done kind of a two-layer approach here. They've broken this out on the different categories or different process that they'll go through within the job. So if I click on one of these, it'll show me the items that are needed to complete the flooring portion of the job. Same thing with the plumbing and the electrical and so on. So on this, you'll see that the cost here is displayed in the extended cost, but they also have the overhead rate and the profit rate for each of those items, along with the cost code. Whenever we're looking at building our proposals, there's two ways that you can kind of categorize your proposal. You can do it by bid item, otherwise known as these items up here, these kind of categories or subheadings, or you can group them by cost code to see in total how many with this cost code, what is the total price for my customer. To export this onto the 6-9 screen, the easiest way to go about this, once your takeoff is done being built, is to go up to Export, go down to Proposal, and you'll have two options available to you, by cost code or bid item. This is going to help dictate how it appears for your client. So if you want it to show all of the electrical items and the total, you'll want to choose by bid item. If you want to show by cost code and the totals for that cost code, you'll want to hit by cost code. You'll note that down here, our bid amount total is the equivalent of our cost plus our profit and overhead that we've added on per item. So our bid is now $55,300 even. I'm going to do by cost code, and this is just because it's the top one. There's no specific reason why. You'll want to see what is easiest for your company. If this job is something that is going to be progress billed, and you need to show the cost codes on your progress bill, then this will be something that you'll want to think about ahead of time. Most companies do use the by cost code method. So I'm going to hit this on, and I'll get a pop open that says any existing proposals for this job once I export are going to be overwritten by this new proposal. So I'm going to hit yes, and it'll give me a confirmation that that was complete. I'm going to go ahead and go and navigate to my 6-9 screen and verify that that is the new balance of my proposal. So I will pull up 224, and you'll see that each cost code was carried over with the material, labor, and the breakout of how it got to that total by cost code. You'll also see that down here, the bid amount or the proposal amount is still at $55,300. From here, you can go ahead and email this out or distribute it how you'd like and continue on with your workflow. However, this process right here allows you to kind of streamline the concept of double entering maybe some items that the takeoff already contains. It helps save you some time on getting the cost codes correct and even the dollar amounts correct for what you anticipate to bill from. From there, you are good to go to move on to your next workflow item for your company. It's just as simple as that. The takeoff screen really helps you automate and export things that really would take some time to develop whenever you're setting up a new job. If you have any questions or want to take a deeper dive at how this can apply for your company, please feel free to give me a call or send me an email. The best way to get in contact with me is to send me a note at coordinator@bangerinc.com. Thanks, y'all. Have a good day.